Our last variation for ice tables is the third way to solve for an x value, to solve for equilibrium values for substances. And this is if neither one of the shortcuts that we've already presented works. So if you don't have perfect squares or if you don't have a small k value, then that means that we are going to be limited to using the quadratic. For this example, we're going to use the reaction of the decomposition of PCl5. Notice that this will not be perfect squares. This equation is already balanced. We don't have a coefficient of 2 for our reactant, so perfect squares won't work. We don't have a very small k, so we can't assume that x is going to be 0. And so that means that we're going to have to use our quadratic equation. So this is our formula for the quadratic. We'll work through the example of it. And in case you've never heard it, for a little fun, if you want to look it up, you can learn to sing the formula of the quadratic to the tune of Pop Goes the Weasel. You're welcome. All right, so again, we are working with this scenario. Here we have an ice table set up. And notice for this one, we are given gas pressures. So again, in our ice table, we can use molarities or pressures. We're going to stick with pressures on this one. We are given the volume of the container, but we don't need to use that with our pressures. So that is extraneous information. For this one, we are told we're starting with 0.320 atmospheres of PCl5, which means we assume we have 0 of our products. So drawing that squiggly line under our arrow, we know that our products are going to have to increase because they start at 0 and our reactant decreases. Everything is a coefficient of 1, which means on our change line, everything is just a coefficient of 1 for our x. Setting up our equilibrium line, we get 0.320 minus x for PCl5, x for PCl3, and x for Cl2. Now for our next steps, we go through the same process. So we have our equation written. We have our ice table done. Our next step is to write our equilibrium expression. And of course, we're using pressures and we're given a Kp. So we're going to use our Kp expression. So the pressure of PCl3, the pressure of Cl2, the pressure of PCl5 on the bottom. Everything has a coefficient of 1 and is order 1. And now when we plug in our equilibrium values, we get this equation and set that equal to our Kp value. So we now have a math equation to solve. Again, recognizing we don't have perfect squares. Our denominator is not a square. We don't have a small k value, so none of our other shortcuts will work. But we do have this math equation. We can now solve for our polynomial, setting everything equal to 0 so that we can set up for our quadratic. So remember, to set up our equation to use the quadratic, we want to set everything equal to 0. So that means I need to multiply both sides by my denominator. And I'm going to distribute the 1.42 by both substances or both values. So 1.42 times 0.32 is 0.04544 minus 1.42x. And now again, I need to move everything to one side to set it equal to 0. I prefer starting with a positive x squared. So I'm going to move both of my quantities on the right over to the left. So we get x squared plus 1.42x. minus 0.4544, and all of that is equal to 0. So remember, in our quadratic, x is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root b squared minus 4ac over 2a. And so the a, b, and c in this equation represent the coefficients for each term. So the a is always in the highest order term, the coefficient. So a is going to be 1. B is the coefficient in front of my next term. That will be 1.42. And C is the quantity in front of my last term, paying attention to sign. So C is actually going to be a negative 0.4544. And so when we plug all of that into our quadratic equation, it turns out we actually get two solutions. And so x, you'll always get two solutions, right? Your highest order will tell you the number of solutions. We get a negative 1.689 or a 0.269. And so we have to evaluate which one is the correct answer. Realize in our ice table, we have just x's at equilibrium. Well, we can never have a negative concentration or pressure. So any negative sign, that value is automatically crossed out. So it has to be this one. But realize even if both of my quantities, my solutions for x were positive, if we go back to our ice table, it turns out that when we plug values in, if they're both positive, one of them, when I plug in for PCl5, would give me a negative value. And so whichever one is negative or returns a negative value can't be the valid answer. So in this one, we know our final solution for X is 0.269. And so when you go back to your ice table to plug everything in, again, PCl5 is calculated as our initial 0.320 minus our 0.269. Again, we're subtracting, so we're going by decimal places, and so that's how we get the 0.051 atmospheres. For PCl3 and Cl2, those were just values of x, and so x is our final answer for those. And again, you can plug quantities in and either estimate that they give the right K value, or you can plug values directly in and make sure that you get the right answer. So notice with this K value, we should have slightly more products than reactants, which we do. Or you could plug directly back into here and make sure you get the right K value. And I just noticed this should be a KP on this slide, not a KC.